Hello everyone and welcome to the Lunchalot Gaming channel, and I know what you're all thinking straight away. Lunchalot, you did a video on the Stargate mount 2 days ago. What can possibly have changed in the meantime? Well, actually quite a lot, and as is traditional on this channel, a major update for the mod got released the day after I released my video. So this update added consumables, and I'll just show you quickly what they do, and then after that we will go ahead and show you how to craft them. It also added a new skin, which I'm very excited to look at. So, the consumables that got added, we've got MREs, military rations, meal ready to eat, which is a type of food that doesn't have any spool timer whatsoever. They added a med kit, which give you health back, a painkillers, which also give you health back that can be used on humans and dinos. Med kits are humans only, and MREs are humans only. They also added tritonin, which is a substance which heals you. It gives you about 1,000 health back, so it's really powerful and can be used by humans and dinos. And they added an ancient gene, which allows the use of ancient technology. I don't think that feature's implemented yet, but will probably come in when there's drones and stuff. Can be used in humans and dinos, but its main thing at the moment is that it reduces weight in your inventory, which is amazing. So the painkillers, dinos can use them on their own, so if you leave a stack of them in their inventory, they'll auto-consume them. So let's test these out a bit. Okay, so as you can see, I've run down my health and my food quite a bit, mostly using the hurt me command for all you masochists out there. So let's test out some of these things. So firstly, the MRE. As I said, food without a spool timer. I'm expecting this will take my food probably back up to full, but we shall see. Yeah, that's going on really fast. It's also giving me a decent health regeneration, which is the eating buff, which is fine. Cool. Yeah, straight back up to full, one meal, and they last forever. So painkillers. Painkillers give you about 70 health back. And what's that buff say? Healing fatigue. You will take more damage than normal during this time. That's an interesting balance. I like that. And then it's got a, what was that? Probably a 2 minute timer. So we're on 288 health now. So let's take a med kit. And that's refreshed our healing fatigue timer. And again, that's on a 2 minute timer as well. And where were we? We were on 288. So that was nearly 200 health, essentially. And then if I just hurt me 400 again. Oh, oops. Okay, there we go. That's what I was after, hurt me 400. So the last thing we want to try is the tritonin, which should do 1,000 points worth of healing. So that should take me right up to full again. And that is tritonin. Yeah, okay, cool. So that just gives you a rundown of what it does. And I've just spawned in some more tritonin, so we can see that's a much longer cooldown timer. So that's what, 260-ish seconds, something like that, which is interesting, possibly even 280. So yeah, that will take a lot longer to respawn. Final thing I wanted to check out is the ancient gene. So I am now massively over encumbered, I can't move. But if I inject myself with the ancient gene, and bear in mind this works on dinos as well, so like take an Anki's weight reduction for metal and then add this on top. So I misread the thing, which is my bad. So the ancient gene reduces the weight of the mod resources. So like that's 1,000, and it goes down to 87 when it's in my inventory. So yeah, that's a huge weight reduction. So it's a 90% weight reduction on everything. Lunchalot doing maths, fail. But it doesn't affect vanilla items, so all of the stone and everything will be exactly the same. So yeah, glad I figured that one out. And then yeah, so mod resources get a weight reduction because they are quite heavy and you do need a lot of them. Right, in order to craft these things, let's have a look. So, medicines. Painkillers, which is probably the most simple one. You need narcotic stimulants and tinto berries for the med kit. You need narcotics, painkillers, stimulants, and tinto berries. So that kind of builds on that. And you need twice as much as you did before. And then for the tritonin, you need a med kit, narcotic stimulants, tinto berries, 0 point energy and liquid naquida, and I'll just show you what 0 point energy costs and liquid naquida. So resources. So liquid naquida is crystal and naquida ingots. 0 point energy is gold ingots and liquid naquida. So they are quite expensive, but very well worth it. And the final thing, the ancient gene. And MREs, I'll get to those in a second. Requires liquid naquida, measure berries, narcotics, stimulants, and 0 point energy. So yeah, they're fairly expensive to craft, but once you've got things rolling, you should be okay. And the ancient gene, you use it once and it's permanent. Like I can't actually, I spawned in another one because I thought I'd done something wrong. Turns out you can't use it on yourself again, it is a permanent enhancement. And MREs are 2 cooked meat, 5 manjo berry, 3 rock carrot, and 2 sour root. So you'll need a bit of crops going in order to make those. Right, and last thing to check out, which I'm really excited about, is the skin. Okay, so the armor is Jafar armor, Horus, and then this is the skin. You need 10 gold ingots and 25 liquid naquida. And I'm hoping to see more of these in the future. And I'll just very quickly craft myself a hat. A cloth hat, doesn't have to be fancy. So it's taking a while to craft, but I imagine this will be well worth it once it's ready. Okay. Let's apply it and stick it on our head. And let's check this out. I'm excited. Are you excited? Oh, that looks awesome. The detailing on the model is really good. Loving it. This full set of flak as well, you'll start to look the part. But yeah, that is awesome. Cool. Can you imagine like a whole tribe players coming out of the night with these on? Okay, that's great. Well, that's the updates to the mod. They've also changed the Lantian Fabricator's health. This one's an old one, so if I put down a new one, it should. Have the correct health now, which is 5,000. And big thank you to the mods for continuing to work on this, because it's a really cool mod. And if you've enjoyed it at any point, then please like, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications. The way I'm doing this channel now, I'm trying to keep people updated as to what's going on with mods, as well as just showcasing the new ones that come into the workshop, particularly mods that we've already featured. So I should hopefully have a video on the new Glacius cave coming shortly, and we do Primal Fear live streams, or the Hunted live streams, or just live streams in general pretty much every night of the week. So pop along to one of those and say hi if you feel like it. Anyway, have an absolutely great day, and goodbye.